Uden en kombi. That's... Friends, please stop talking. Before the break, we were discussing AS20 earnings per share. The standard required disclosure of EPS. The standard required disclosure of EPS. There are two EPS it requires to disclose on the face of P&L. One basic EPS, other one dilutive EPS. Basic EPS, earnings attributable to equity shareholders, PACE, divided by weighted average number of equity shares, VANES. Profit attributable to equity shareholders equal to PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend. Then we have VANES, weighted average number of equity shares. It is weighted average number of equity shares equal to number of shares as multiplied by two weights. One is called period weight, the other one is called paid up value weight. Then after we solved the problems, we discussed the effect of bonus issue. We told you that the period should be counted from the date of normal issue, but always it is not issue, it is from the effective dates. Okay. The bonus will be considered as if it is outstanding in the previous year as well as in the current year. Then we discuss bonus element in rights issue, which will be computed as fair value divided by theoretical exercise price. What is theoretical exercise price? We discuss how to apply bonus element in computation of VANES, we discussed. Then we introduced dilutive EPS. Dilutive EPS is actually potential reduction in EPS arising from prospective increase in VANES without increase in resources. Diluted EPS equal to basic earnings plus savings in interest, dividend, etc. divided by basic VANES plus prospective VANES. Everybody? Okay. So then, we discussed about certain instrument that cause dilution, because dilution means reduction. The reduction may be out of two reasons, either because of reduction in profits or increase in number of shares. I want all of you to put your mind here and please listen. So it is like this, it is reduction in, either reduction in profit or increase in number of shares. In that we told you we are not going to discuss about the reduction in profit, it is only increase in number of shares. So that way we do take only the increase in VANES for the purpose of computing diluted EPS. Understood, Prasanna? So diluted EPS equal to basic earnings. Earnings that has been considered for the purpose of basic EPS plus savings in interest, dividend, etc. Because of the conversion of debentures, preference shares, etc. divided by basic VANES plus prospective VANES. Correct, Appa? So then we did problem based on conversion of debentures. Suppose if it was convertible preference capital, then how it will be? It will have basic earnings plus preference dividend plus tax or minus tax? Plus tax, dividend distribution tax. These are the two amounts which has been originally reduced from profits. Now both these amounts will be added back. Basic earnings plus preference dividend plus dividend distribution tax. Divided by basic VANES plus prospective VANES. Everybody respond. In case of convertible preference share capital, this is how you will be making the adjustment for the earnings, basic earnings plus preference dividend plus dividend distribution tax. Correct? Now, impact of option. Option is an instrument that provides a holder to subscribe for the shares of the company at a predetermined price on a future date. We told this. And we introduce dash concept. ESOP. Correct? So it is an instrument which gives the holder a right to buy shares many are there in the switch off mode, half sleep mode, dreams mode. I just want you to come back to the class. We are discussing AS20, last part of AS20, dilution, which is caused by three instruments. What are the three instruments? Convertible debentures, convertible preferential, option. What is option means is what we are discussing. That is an instrument that provides a holder to buy shares on a future date, which we already discussed when we discuss ESOP. Correct, Abba? So in future, there could be a possibility of increase in number of shares without increase in resources, what we convey. Correct, Abba? So option is an instrument giving the holder a right to buy the shares of the company at a price. So which means, no, at a price, correct? Which means that particular option holders will give money and we will give issue shares. Correct? The option holders will give money and we will issue shares to them. Could you appreciate that? Yes, so in that case, is it the shares increasing with resources or without resources? Here the options are increasing without resources or with the resources. It is actually increasing with the resources. We discussed that. So option means it is an instrument which entitles the holder to subscribe the shares of the company at a predetermined price. At a predetermined price. When I issue share, I am going to get cash. Understood? Then the shares are increasing with resource or without resource? It is with resource, we are getting cash. Are you following? Respond. But for dilution, do we take shares increasing with the resources or without resources? We'll take only shares without resources. But option is increasing in share with or without resources? It is with resource. Then should option be considered for dilution? Is always a question mark. Correct? In that case, option cannot be considered for dilution. So please understand, I don't know why you are saying yes or no at all. I don't know, you are not at all applying your mind at all, no common sense applied here. Are you following this? So the concept is that we are telling, so in option, the option is increasing the number of shares with increase in resources. For dilution, we consider only the shares increasing without resources. Understood? So in that case, we should understand, then why do you consider option for the purpose of dilution? Why should I consider option for the purpose of here? Now the next question or the next concept arises, that you are correct, that in option there is some hidden bonus. In option there is some, so thereby through option I am not going to consider all the shares. We are not going to consider, we are going to consider only bonus in option. What is that? Bonus in option. So this bonus in option is not like bonus in elemental rights issue and all. So this is a separate concept. Bonus in option will be expressed in specific number of shares. Bonus in option will be expressed in specific number of shares. So how to express that? It is very simple. For example, imagine fair value equal to rupees 80, issue price equal to rupees 50, number of options being 1,50,000, which means in future there are certain people to whom I am given some right to buy how many shares at rupees when the market price is 80. Understood? In future, the number of shares is going to increase by 1,50,000. But all these 1,50,000 future number of shares, I am not going to consider for dilution. Only in this 1,50,000, some bonus is included, that I am going to consider. They appreciate that. We are discussing called impact of option. We are not taking all the options, friends. We are going to take only bonus in option. So we should know how to compute bonus. Correct, Appa? Please respond. So bonus in option formula is like this, ba. Number of options into concession per share divided by fair value per share. Number of options into concession per share divided by fair value per share. What is that concession per share? 30 rupees. So how to compute in this problem? It is 1,50,000 into rupees 30 divided by rupees 80. 56,000 is called a bonus in option. So what is the formula for bonus in option? Bonus in option equal to number of option into concession per divided by fair value per share. Everybody, now 1,50,000 into 30 divided by 80. Everybody? Okay. 56,250 shares. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Now proceeding. Just to understand or make you understand this logic behind this formula, shall we?
Yes, sir.
Because too many logics I don't want to carry forward. Again, this is a logic not there in books. Now listen, it's a simple concept only. The standard says there is bonus in this option only because this issue price is less than the fair value, not face value, fair value. Understood? Everybody. Now, what is the concession we are offering? If that concession was not offered, then there is no bonus. If that concession was not there, then there is no bonus. Now listen carefully. I am going to issue one share at rupees 50. How many shares I am issuing? So please keep your calculator, friend, and make the calculation. What will be the max amount I am going to collect? What is the maximum collection I am going to have? 75 lakhs. Now by collecting 75 lakhs, imagine I don't want to give bonus to shareholders. I should issue shares to the shareholders at what rupees? If I issue at 80, you will tell no bonus?
Yes, sir.
Respond. So imagine after collecting 75 lakhs, if I issue the share at rupees 80, how many shares I would have issued? How many shares I would have issued? 93,000. But according to the contract, I am actually issuing 1,50,000. Respond. If there is no bonus, the number of shares that would have been issued would have been 93,000. But actually I am issuing 1,50,000, which means I am giving you some free shares. How many shares? 56,250, which is the bonus. Are you following? That's a concept that we have. It is like this. After collecting money, if I tell no bonus to you, I should issue the share at 80 rupees, which means I should have given only 93,750. But according to contract, I am actually giving you the extra take shares. 56,250 bonus. That bonus only you should consider for the option. Understood? This is the logic for that formula. Everybody, so what you did, you actually computed total money received. Respond. What is total money received? Number of option into issue price. Correct? Number of option into issue price. That is, you computed like this. 1,50,000 into 50. Everybody, divided by 80. You get how what? 1,50,000 into 50 divided by 80. You get? This you reduce from 1,50,000.
Yes,
correct? If I take 1,50,000 common, it is 1 minus 50 by 80.
Yes,
everybody. So which is nothing but 1,50,000 into 80 minus 50 by 80.
Yes,
sir. This is a formula they developed. You should develop this formula only. This common sense only was developed into formula. What is that? 1,50,000 into concession. 80 minus 50 divided by fair value. Are you following? Everybody. So after receiving total money, if I say no bonus to you, I should have issued the share at 80. So which means I should have issued only 93,000. But I am giving 1,50,000, so 56,250 is bonus. Everybody, that bonus only will consider for? Will be considered for? ஆப்ஷன் இல்லப்பா. தட் போனஸ் இன் ஆப்ஷன் ஒன்லி வில் பி கன்சிடர் ஃபார் லைஃப் டிவிஷன். இன் கேஸ் ஆஃப் போனஸ் இன் ஆப்ஷன், நோ அட்ஜஸ்ட்மெண்ட் இன் ஏர்னிங்ஸ், நோ சேவிங்ஸ் அட் ஆல், ஜஸ்ட் இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஷேர்ஸ். டிபென்சர்ஸ், ப்ரிஃபரன்ஸ் ஷேர்ஸ் என்றால் மேபி டைல்யூட்டிவ், மேபி ஆன்டி டைல்யூட்டிவ், மேபி ஆர் பிகாஸ் சம்டைம்ஸ் இட் கேன் ரிசல்ட் இன் டு டைல்யூட்டட் இபிஎஸ் இஸ் மோர் தென் பேசிக் இபிஎஸ், பட் ஆப்ஷன்ஸ் ஆர் ஆல்வேஸ் டைல்யூட்டிவ், ஆப்ஷன்ஸ் ஆர் ஆல்வேஸ் டைல்யூட்டிவ். குட் அப்ரிஷியேட் தட், பிகாஸ் தேர் இஸ் நோ சேவிங்ஸ் இன் earnings, there is no savings in one. Even if one number of share increased, the value per share will decrease. So thereby options are always dilutive. Would you appreciate that, everybody? Fine. So let us now work out the last question from this problem, the topic AS20 relating to dilution of EPS based on options. Listen, net profit for the year 12 lakhs, number of equity shares outstanding wanes 5 lakhs, fair value 20 rupees, options being 1 lakh, excise price per share is rupees 15. Compute diluted earnings per share. Compute basic and diluted earnings per share. Like that we will take. Everybody? Question number 11. Basic EPS equal to profit pays divided by wanes. That is 12 lakhs divided by 5 lakhs equal to 2.40. Then we have diluted EPS. Diluted EPS. In this, I want first bonus in option, which is equal to number of option into concession divided by fair value per share equal to 1 lakh into 5 by 20. 25,000. Everybody? So diluted EPS equal to same profit of 12 lakhs divided by 5 lakh 25,000. 2.29. That's all. So thus we have covered all forms of dilution. So we have completed basic EPS as well as diluted EPS.